Welcome back, and as we wake up and get out the door this morning, depending on where you live, will mean a different view to what you see as you step out the door, like across areas of southeast Iowa here in Centerville, where you're dealing with a foggier start to the day. Some haziness built there right there now in downtown Centerville as temperatures hover very more on the mild side, with temperatures currently in the mid and lower 40s across the area. Dense fog advisories remain in effect until 9 a.m. for Appanoose, Davis, Monroe, and Wapello counties. However, the fog has begun to lighten up just a little bit, not seeing as much of an extension down towards the Missouri and Iowa border, but mild conditions as we wake up, but they will not stick around as we go throughout the entirety of today's forecast. So as you're heading out the door, you're going to need a lighter jacket than what you will want as you're heading home from work. And parents, as you're heading home from work, you're probably going to want to break out some of those heavier coats, hats, gloves, and scarves. But by the time we are heading out the door tomorrow morning, overnight tonight into tomorrow morning, temperatures are going to end up bottoming out in the teens, with wind chill values as low as about 5 degrees above zero. So a very different feel for the start of the day tomorrow compared to this morning. Can't stress it enough. Be ready for the blast of just Arctic cold air that will be arriving in highs tomorrow, not even likely to exceed 32 degrees despite the mostly sunny skies. And then these temperatures this morning are where the highs are going to end up being at here today. So over the next few hours, light rainfall that we had from this morning is all going to work its way off to the east, and eventually a cold front is going to fall through, and you can see where the cold air on the backside of that front is going to make an impact. So we started this morning off very mild, but even prior to noon, you're looking at temperatures across areas of southeast Iowa already dropping down towards and even potentially below the freezing threshold of 32 degrees. So as that light snow begins to work its way in, it rolls across mainly southeast Iowa, leaving us with very little accumulation. Can't stress that enough, very little accumulation. But prior to the time kids are heading home from school near 3 to 4 p.m., you're already going to be looking at a majority of the heartland below freezing, with some areas like Centerville already dropping into the mid and lower 20s. So really stress bringing your heavier coat with you as you head out the door this morning. And despite not needing it now, you will need it as you are heading home from school, as the parents are heading home from work, because temperatures will continue to bottom out. And then near 3 to 4 p.m., already looking at temperatures closing in on just 20 degrees in Albia as well as Centerville. So getting even closer to just the teens by the time the kids are heading home from school. And then parents, you can guess it, and you can assume temperatures will be dropping into the teens by the time you are heading home from work. Wind chill values dropping into the single digits through the overnight hours. And then tomorrow morning, just a bitterly cold start to the day. So really cannot stress it enough. Make sure you're fully ready for the cold, cold air. So once this cold front moves across the area, high pressure is going to build in behind it. So that'll take care of any kind of precipitation that we should expect for late day today and then through a majority of the upcoming work week. But the temperatures cannot be taken too lightly. 10, 15, almost 20 degrees below normal for high temperatures starting tomorrow and lasting through at least Wednesday's forecast before we finally start to see some relief in the form of a warming temperature trend arrive for the end of the work week. But now let's go ahead and send it back to Ella.